Hello students, today's lecture is class 11th physics, and in previous lecture we have discussed about some topics related to error, and in this video lecture we'll be continued the lecture based on error. And there is error are two types. First, random errors, and second one is systematic error. Random errors cannot be removed permanently, but systematic errors can be removed, because random errors is the random factors that affects the measurement, but the systematic error is occurred in the process. Like if we are measuring the weight of an object by the different measuring devices, and then when we measure different measuring devices of mass of an object, then there will be something difference. Suppose that the mass is measured by first instrument like 5.1 kilogram, and second 5.2 kilogram, third 5.05 kilograms, like this. But there will be a mean value, and then we can add the values of different measuring instruments. So then we will able to check out the mean value which is measured by different measuring devices. Now, random errors and systematic errors, what is the difference between random and systematic errors? That's it. Random errors cannot be removed permanently, but systematic error can be tried to remove, but totally cannot be removed, okay? Because there is no 100% accuracy to measure the unit of any physical quantity. So 100% accuracy is not possible, but something it seems to be like 99.8, 99.9% accuracy can be. So that accuracy can be ideal. We can suppose ideal. So we can say that systematic errors can be removed. Now, in this system, errors can be calculated in three processes. First, absolute error, and second is relative error, third is percentage error. Always remember that these are methods to calculate the error, not it's a type of error. It is a method to calculate the error. Now, if we are going to calculate the errors produced in a measuring devices, then there are three ways. First is absolute error, second is relative error, and third is percentage error. So we are going with the topic absolute error. Suppose that there are few values represented by different measuring devices. Let different values of a physical quantity by a measuring device, suppose A1, A2, A3, A4, and a n. Okay, so here we can say that we can find the a mean. That is, there are given some values and all values will be different to each other. Then how can we solve and how can we find the an average error? So we have to find the mean value of this values. Like a mean, okay, a mean equals to a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus a4 dot dot plus an and divided by the number of terms. The number of values is n, so we can write here a mean equals to a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus a4 plus dot dot an, and whole the summation can be divided by number of terms n. So we can write here a mean that is equal to summation of an, where the value of n will be initiated to 1 and going to the n numbers. Okay, so a mean can be calculated as summation of a n, where the value of n will starts to 1 and goes to n. So there is the mean. Now the absolute error, that is equal to the difference of true value and the practical value. There is, we can write here the true value and take your difference sign and write here practical value. That is the absolute error. And absolute error can be denoted as delta A. And the error will be always positive. So write here mod of delta A. Okay? So if we are calculating here the mod of A, then you can write here the true value and the difference of practical value. But in this case, there should be, if we are going to solve the absolute error, then the true value should be taken as a mean. Okay, so here we can write as delta A that is equal to A minus A mean. That is the formula. And in next, if we are going to calculate the relative error, then point number second, relative error. The definition of relative error is the relative error can be defined as the ratio of delta A mean and A mean. A mean means that is the all the given values of by the measuring devices, and this is the mean of absolute errors. Then this the ratio will call the relative error. So we can write here relative error equals to, there is the ratio of delta A mean upon a mean. Okay, that is the relative error. Now, how can we find out the value of delta a mean? Suppose that there are few values which is measured by the different devices A1, A2, A3, F4, F5 and dot dot on AM. So if we are going to calculate the A mean, then we can write here A mean equals to A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus dot dot AN and divided by the number of terms, that is N. So we can find the value of A mean from here. But if we are going to solve delta A mean, then it will be A1 minus A mean. If we are going to delta A2, that is the A2 minus A mean, and so on, that is the delta AN, that is equal to AN minus A mean. Okay? So here we can say that delta mod of delta AB, delta AN, that is equal to mod of delta A1 plus mod of delta A2 plus mod of delta A3 and so on to the delta AN, like this, and divided by the number of terms, that is the N. So you can find here delta AN. Okay, so here the formula is A mean and the delta A mean. Delta A mean is this. So write here delta A mean, delta A mean equals to mod of delta A1 plus mod of delta A2 plus mod of delta A3 and so dot dot mod of delta AN and divided by number of terms N. So there is a formula to determine the delta A mean, and here is the formula to determine the value of A mean. So if we are able to find the value of A mean and delta A mean, then put both values in the formula for the relative error, that is the delta A mean upon A mean. So according to this formula, we can solve the questions related to the relative error. And the next one topic is percentage error. Actually, it is totally next step to the relative errors. Now, if we are going to the topic of percentage error, percentage error, then this is the percentage value of relative error actually. Now, if there is written that there is a value of relative error, relative error into 100 in the mod equals to delta A upon A, that is the delta A mean, and here A mean into 100, and all the values should be in the mod. So relative error can be represented as into 100, then it will become percentage error. For example, if there is a measuring device and it measures 2.5 meter. And what is the, this is the length 2.5 meter, which is measured by a measuring device and calculate the error which is occurred in this process. Then there we have to calculate the least count. Then how can we solve and how can we find the least count? Least count should be taken as, see here, before the last point take 0 in the place of all digit and the last digit in the place of last digit take 1. Like here is written that 2, so take here 0 and there is a decimal, so take decimal. And last point is 5, in the place of 5 write here 1. That is the least count and it is denoted as delta A. So the error, relative error, that can be in the form of delta L upon L, that will be equal to the measured value is total 2.5 and the least count is 0.1. So take here delta A upon A, that is the A. So here delta A equals to 0.1 and divided by A, that is the 2.5. Now you can check here delta L upon L, that is equal to 1 upon 25. You can write here. So there is the value of 0.4. This is the delta L upon L. This value is a relative error. But if we are going to solve it in the percentage error, then write here mod of delta L upon L into 100. And this value will be maximum and equals to right here delta A upon A into 100 and this format is called the percentage error and total value is delta A equals to 0.1 and A is 2.5 into 100. Then 0.1 can be written as 1 upon 25 into 100. So you can cut here 25 for the 100. So there is the answer of this question is 4%. So mod of delta L upon L into 100 maximum, that is equal to 4%. So there is a percentage error equals to 4% for this measuring device. So according to these conditions you can solve the questions and next video lecture we will make and next time. So solve the questions based on the relative error, absolute error and the percentage error. So aaj ka video bas itna hai. Thank you.